in a lot of technologies, you sort of plod along for many years, sometimes decades, and suddenly it becomes good enough and then it takes off. So I think we're just on the other side of this need for speech and language technologies.
Children's speech is becoming very popular because everybody wants to recognize the speech, not only adult speech, but also children's speech. So every application you know is looking for it.
Some of the projects we're doing involve improving speech recognition for children's voices. Children's speech is fundamentally different qualitatively. I believe this will have a fairly big impact on this kind of research about children's development, language environments.
We need to find ways to adapt or modify the current algorithms to make it work to children's speech. So that is our main challenge. And it's not an easy task.
So one of the difficulties in doing this kind of research is that you have to record a child's listening environment for a whole day or a couple of days, and then try and write down, try and analyze how many words the child spoke, how much was spoken by the mother or the father or some other caregiver.
The hypothesis at first, it was that it was the number of words that make the brain grow. But then they found out that no, it is the interaction between the kid and other people.
What it means is we can't just focus on speech transcription technology. We have to think about voice type detection, language ID, speaker identification. You need all of these to work for this technology to be able to help these people solve their problems. So doing this kind of cross-disciplinary work is very much in the DNA of Hopkins. Our group is unique in the sense that we have a large enough group that we have all the expertise we need to work on this problem.
People thought that ASR, the speech recognition, and the diarization is already a solved problem. And whenever they come to children's speech, they find out that is not. The error rates are quite high. So that is really surprising. So whenever you want to test your system, go to children's speech first.
This is where the technology doesn't work today. And if you can make it work here, it'll benefit many other applications. So in that sense, this is important both for the particular purpose that we're working on, but more generally in making the technology more robust. And so then you're also reaching out to covering low resource languages. So these are languages for which there isn't enough technology, and you're leaving certain segments of population out of the benefits of these technologies. So what is exciting about it is this current time in this field, where a lot of the hard work we've been doing over the last 20, 25 years is finally bearing fruit, and real applications are coming out, and it's impacting the lives of real people.